Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. This video is sponsored by Sonoran Desert Institute. If you're interested in a career in the ever-growing firearms industry, arm yourself with an education. Sonoran Desert Institute offers online learning like armorer courses all the way up to an associate degree. Visit sdi.edu or call 480-999-4767 to learn more. Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. Going to the range is therapeutic. It's peaceful. It's calming. It's a sense of self. I find myself. You know, it's like some people go to the gym. Some people go to their favorite restaurant. We go to the range to have a great time. We get our gear ready. We get the right ammo. And we head off to the range expecting to have a great time. But sometimes things turn out to be a disaster. Now, when that happens, it is typically either user error or equipment failure. And this weekend, I experienced both. Now, I don't mind user error. All right, that gives us a chance to learn. What did I do wrong? What do I have to remember next time? Where does this gun impact? You know, how am I shooting low? What am I doing with this gun that I didn't do with the other gun? That's all good stuff. And I don't mind rain. I don't mind snow and cold weather. I know what I'm getting into. But there are other things that are outright stupid, and I've experienced it all this weekend. Now, the weekend started out great. I picked up a new golf cart. It's a 2018 EasyGo gas-powered golf cart. I wanted one for years. I had this customized a bit, and I don't know what's going on in Michigan or the surrounding states because I checked all over the place, but golf carts are in high demand right now, and I was able to get this 2018 EasyGo, and I'm thinking, all right, off to a good start. Can't wait to get to the range and complete the weekend. So I go to the National Forest, which is where I go, and I have to set up my targets. And I did pick up a couple new targets. These came in just today, so they are not on video yet, but I did pick up a couple more targets. I have two ranges, typically, that I use, and then I try to build up those ranges so that, you know, they're challenging and they're exciting and whatever. So I picked up these targets afterward. But I set up, and people that make videos, you'll understand this. I went to turn my camera on. It stayed on for about 5 minutes and then completely died out. I had the wrong battery in there. What a dummy. I've been doing this for years, and I still forget to put the charged battery in there. Wouldn't it be wise to charge both batteries? So I had to take everything away. I had all my guns and ammo on a table. I had to pack it all up, go get the right battery, and come back. Many times I go to the range, I don't even bring a camera. I go just for that therapeutic experience. But other times I want to bring a camera and share what I'm doing and feature it in front of you guys. So that happened. Then I have the Axel Ghost Strike 2, the hearing protection that I touted a couple videos ago. I love that those things too. They're great. They work outstanding. It enhances the hearing, but they are battery operated. And guess what I did? I left the battery on. No different than leaving your red dot on that doesn't turn off automatically. And then you go to the range to use your rifle or whatever, and it doesn't work. And you look and you say, what was I thinking? So I put these in, all excited because it was only my second time with these, and I hear deet, 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 deet. And so I'm like, the battery's dead because I left it on the whole time. What a dummy. So I'm 0 for 2 on batteries, okay? User failure. But then I was shooting this 1911, this para. It's unloaded. And now when you shoot a 1911, it's best to put your strong side some over the thumb safety so it doesn't engage when shooting, all right? You can be confident that is not going to engage. But if you put your thumb underneath the thumb safety and you experience recoil, which you will with 45, it's very likely that it could engage that. Then you pull the trigger, nothing happens, and you realize that you made that mistake. Now, I know better. I've been shooting 1911s. I know better. But it still happened. It happened on video. And if you watch my next video, you will see that. And I didn't cover it up or anything. I showed exactly what happened and how I messed that up. The one handgun, one shotgun, one rifle series that I've been running, it's my favorite series. The hardest thing to get is rifles and shotguns. I have plenty of handguns to feature, but once I already used all of my rifles and shotguns, I have friends who loan me theirs. I talked about Greg. He also loaned me the shotgun and rifle for this next video, and here is his Mini 30. Now, this is a nice rifle, and I love Vortex optics. This is a Crossfire 2 made by Vortex. I took a few shots. I was bench resting it because this Hoag stock is really heavy. I mean, it is heavy. And so as I'm bench resting it, I take a couple shots and the optic goes completely blurred. Blurred. And I was looking around to see if a lens popped out or what could have happened. I have no idea, but the optic went completely blurred. Now, thankfully, Vortex has a lifetime warranty, and I am fully confident that they're going to take care of it. But I had to contact my buddy and say, oh, by the way, rifle performed well, but the optic didn't. And I hate that. You know, you borrow something and then something goes wrong. You have to tell them that. So that's what I did. Now, this is, and that was equipment failure, but this is also equipment failure. Now, here's my Zastava M70 AB2 AK variant. Okay, it is unloaded here. I have a Elfman AK trigger. Okay, can you see that? It's a flat trigger. This trigger feels great. It's a flat trigger, real light. Seemingly a nice strike, but ever since this was installed, okay, I'm not sure if you can see that, but it's red in there. That's consistent with Elfman triggers. They got out of the AK business. They said, you know what? Some of their triggers required some gunsmithing. Not all AKs are a spec, and so they got out of it. But this trigger, from the time I had it installed, which it's not adjustable, has or creates light primer strikes. I get two or three shots off, and I experience light primer strikes. And that's what I had with this. Now, it happened before. I guess for some reason, you know, I wanted to take this out. I haven't shot it in a while. I guess for some reason I thought, well, it's not going to happen anymore. But it happened, and it just piled on to all the things happening that made it a little bit of a miserable experience. Or a couple other things that, you know, I started thinking, good grief, could this, you know, this the therapeutic thing made me very angry, and I was getting a bad attitude and thinking, why do I even do this stuff? But I also remember I do it because I love you. And just like those who played sports, we have bad practices, and sometimes we have a bad range day, and you just have to get over it. If you like videos like this, please subscribe and share. I always appreciate the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and you guys be safe.